God. So that's a high one.
How are you feeling, Prophetess? Luring the echo like that, it must have strained you.
Nothing some apple cake couldn't solve. I'll cope. This place, it feels peculiar.
It does, indeed. We are in the consciousness of a past civilization. Do you see that up there? Yaela was right after all. This is our Numinas, the essence of a High One.
Extract the Numinos. There's a body there. Oh, he's talking about Yaela, his wife. Is it conscious? Can it defend itself?
In spite of everything.
We have done it. We've done it. Doesn't the High One feel that we're here? Why doesn't he, she, it do anything?
We are in his thoughts. What could you do against that? Time does not exist here. At least not as we know it.
Watch, it's me. We're in my own thoughts. Because maybe I'm that High One. Still not sure, but, I think either that or I'm from the Pyrenean culture. Or maybe even before that. I went into another eventuality. This one. Well, the one that Tilor and Yuslan and Kalir are from. Either way, I do not think I am native to their eventuality. Anyway, so how do we get the essence inside the container? I don't suppose it works like a Ghostbuster spirit trap thing.
We will see about that. Maybe that question will answer itself. Sharon, do it. Carry the container to the essence.
Do it! Do it now! I can't move. I'm gonna feel something when he does that, aren't I? What do? Teleport up there? I wish I could do that.
What is it?
Can I do that?
What are you waiting for?
Tell me, Aranthiel. Back in the ruins, when the High One showed you that memory, it was the first time I saw you express real agitation. Not anger, but agitation. What you did to your son. Do you regret it, I wonder? That you abandoned him in exchange for prestige and power?
What?
I don't think you do. What got to you was being reminded of your own failure.
Could be,
regret.
I mean,
you don't know that feeling. You never have. Not even after Kira.
We can deal with that later. It is horrible, but
what are you?
We need to stop the High Ones first.
With Kaleen.
What?
I helped him kill Lashari.
What?
And I let the Neremes into the city! And still, you don't have the slightest idea who I am.
I thought the Truchessa did that.
Why? You were there. The night of a thousand fires.
Yes. I survived your massacre. One of only a few.
Then you did not follow my son because you shared his ideals. You did it to get to me. What for, Yuslan? Justice?
Justice? I am done with this world, Aranthiel. I have been for a long time now. The only reason why I'm still here is a promise I made to someone.
Is that me? Because
I promise that one day, I will be the one who takes everything from you.
Okay, that's not something you promised me.
Yusuf, this is madness. Whatever you are planning to do, it will affect the whole world, not just me. If you want my death, why not just wait, damn it?
Yeah, really, this is a little
Once
more than that.
Korek will kill me that way. All those innocent lives
oh,
will
please
be.
Just shut up! You take me for such a fool! As if there's anything in this world you would want more than to die a martyr!
Oh.
Tealor Arathia, conqueror
oh, I can move
of
now.
The High One, savior of mankind. You like the sound of that, don't you? You like it so, so much.
You know, at first, I was so frustrated with all the setbacks. When the Prophetess saved Lashari's research in Alt-Rashengrad, and when Kuarek's first attack on the city didn't succeed. But then I realized that all of this would be so much more gratifying than anything else I could do to you. Your final attempt, and so close to your target, only to fail by my hand.
That doesn't matter in the scheme of everything, though.
You asked me once what my daughter's name was. Do you remember?
Yes, I beg you, please.
Lena. Her name was Lena.
Oh, he...
No.
He messed it up.
That's impossible.
He... I can't get over there, and it's gone. Whoa.
You fool.
What?
Miserable, selfish fool! You killed us all!
Impressive, Arathiel. You really were close. A shame that you were too preoccupied with yourself to see it coming.
Beasts! You damn beast! He was possessed! Possessed from the start!
Oh no, Arathiel. I'm afraid that is only half true. We reap, but you sowed. Of course we possessed him, but you did all the heavy lifting back at Kira when you gave the order to massacre everyone dear to him, including his wife and his poor, poor daughter.
He was behind it all.
And so, it is a happy ending after all, isn't it? Without the Nominos, you have nothing to use the beacon's power on. And the only thing it is good for now is the destruction of your own beloved city. It will be a feast, and there will be nothing left of you once we've devoured you. Nothing but cold, gray flesh. It is just as we say. You have failed as you always have done.
I can't do anything.
What is it, Arathiel? Lost your tongue?
No. No. I have not. Not at all. You have just presented me with a solution.
They have?
Are you deaf? There is no solution. The cleansing will happen. And you will all die.
Oh, he's gonna kill everyone before they can cleanse?
Yes. Yes, we will. Your messiah, the citizens of the city, the armies, we will all burn like the sun. And then it will be over.
You're fantasizing, Arathiel. Without...
Whoa.
Not this time.
Did you do that?
Here we must go our separate ways. Believe me, I wish it were otherwise. But in your condition, you would just be a burden. And I cannot afford any risks. I'm sorry.
How messed up am I right now? What are you talking about? What are you planning?
The High Ones are right. We cannot use the beacon to banish them anymore.
Damn.
But do you remember what the Archmagister said Without the Numinos, the beacon's energy would burst out without direction.
He's going to kill everyone before the cleansing can happen. Which is why we went to find the Numinos in the first place. Lighting the beacon without it would only...
cause a massive explosion. Yes. And that is the only thing we can do for mankind now. Koarek was and is essential to the High One's plan. Whatever shape the actual cleansing takes, he wants to make sure it will happen. And we, Prophetess, we may have failed in breaking the cycle for ourselves, but not for the others.
The others. He's talking about the civilizations to come after us. Is he sure? He wants to kill the High Ones and everyone. But... are you sure it's really... gonna... kill them? And would it really destroy all of mankind? Yeah, a massive explosion, but people could survive. And the High Ones... who's to say it would hurt them? The others, yeah. The other civilizations.
The other people of this world.
Oh.
Araziel, Kira, Kile. They're affected by the cycle as much as Enderal. And I know that there must be people like us. People who have had the same dreams and feel what is about to happen. And if we kill Koarek and his armies, we buy these people time. Time to gather knowledge, time to build a new beacon, and time to light it themselves.
Are you sure? You sure we kill the High Ones that way? Or delay them? You think it would delay the High Ones? So you want to blow up the beacon, but what about Ark? What about all the people who will die?
Those whom the Nerimes have not yet massacred anyway, you mean? They will die, as you and I will. But they will do so for mankind's salvation. And this is something worth dying for.
This is really...
it is the only way, don't you see? Either we die here, rotting with the Pyreans, or we choose to give our death meaning by at least stopping this fanatic Koarek and his armies. The High Ones are a lot weaker than they pretend to be. I feel it. We were so close to destroying them. And I have faith in the others out there who will fight them. They will succeed where this scum Sharim made us fail.
Have you lost your mind, Aranthiel? We can't put a death sentence over all of Enderal just for some vague hope. These people, they trust you.
So, a shepherd cannot decide the fate of his sheep. What is this really about, Prophetess? Your life?
A shepherd?
The life of this woman who is so dear to you.
You're not a shepherd.
Now is not the time for arrogance and selfishness. All of this is about more than just us. That you fail to see this disappoints me, Prophetess. I thought better of you than that.
Well, good for you.
But it does not matter anymore. I've made my choice. I am sorry.
You are not a shepherd. We are not your sheep. You're insane. And I'm passing out or something.
All begins with the dreams.
Huh.
Brave.
I was wondering you'd show up. Ugh. Ow. Investigate the portal. Fleshless. That's pain. I am messed up indeed. There's no way for me to actually get this, right? That's not a failure of mine. I don't think so. Everything descends into chaos. While we manage to summon the High One, and could use the Word of the Dead to dive into its consciousness, but instead of putting the Numinos in the container for the beacon, Sharim, wonderful guy, turned out to be the traitor who went against us from the very beginning. The reason for his betrayal was Aranthiel himself, who was responsible for a massacre called the Night of a Thousand Fires, in which Yuslan's family was killed. Yuslan destroyed the Numinos, in turn killing himself and any hope for humanity. However, Aranthiel doesn't want to give up. He plans to ignite the beacon without the Numinos, which would result in an explosion destroying half of Enderal. Oh, that how much? Okay. But also stopping Korak's armies, a price he is willing to pay. He believes that other countries in this world can build another beacon and succeed on what we failed. But the High Ones are still going to do their thing. I don't see any hint here that... Well, not a hint, but I don't see any indication that the beacon would hurt them without the Numinos. Doesn't say. And nobody's ever specifically said that. It said it would just explode, so it would destroy half of Enderal. Any other continents would be fine. I'm thinking the High Ones would also be fine. So who's to say that it would give the other countries in the world time? That's the only thing. He thinks it would either kill or delay the High Ones, apparently. We have failed. When Aranthiel ordered Yuslan to extract the Numinos, Yuslan revealed that he was playing a double game all this time. He was behind the attack on old Rationgrad. He killed Lashari when she suspected him. So we did find the guy who technically killed him, but I think he hired that guy to poison her. I could be wrong about that. Let the Neremes into the city together with Bartar. Oh, the first time. Wait. You're talking about the first time. The second time was at Truchessa, I guess? The reason behind doing all of that, his family died in a massacre called the Night of a Thousand Fires in Kira, for which Aranthiel was responsible. After Yuslan took his life and, by doing so, destroyed the Numinos, the High Ones possessed his corpse and ridiculed Aranthiel again. Aranthiel now is intent on defying them one last time by igniting the beacon without the Numinos, hence destroying Ark and much of Enderal. In turn, killing himself, the Keepers, Korak's armies, and the civilians, which are still alive, at the same time. So he still doesn't say that it would hurt the High Ones. So we got portal back there.
Enter the mind of a High One? I hope you're joking.
The portal's behind me. Pyrene's temple.
This was their last stand. They are afraid of us. I feel it. You've killed us! You've killed us all! You have just shown me the solution.
They did the same thing. I think this is Yuslan's dead possessed body. This is the portal? Wait a second. Okay, so I'm just curious. Because it looked like it was behind me. Oh no. No. Alright. It did look like it was behind me. And I was just going to go back there, but then ended up investigating.
Into the mind of a high one? I hope you're joking.
This was their last stand. They are afraid of us. I feel it. You've killed us! You've killed us all! You have just shown me the solution.
Oh. It bounced me back. I went too quick. Completed. Still hoping I can find Kalia. So it looks like we're in a Starling area. Wait, where are we? Strange place. Hmm. Strange place. Okay. Yeah, this is Starling stuff. Not star stuff, Starling stuff. What's that?
Oh. No, this is impossible.
Are you talking? Who are you? What is this place? What's that up there?
Why are you here? Be gone, Phantom. Be gone and leave me to my slumber.
Phantom? I notice my character likes to say what in blazes. I don't talk like that. What are you talking about? What's the meaning of this?
Then this isn't a dream. You really are here.
Oh, my blade's all bloody. Look at that.
But why? The Prophet dies when the Emperor leaves him. This is the course of the game. It has always been so.
When the Emperor
leaves. Explain yourself. How did you find this place? And why do you still exist?
That's what I'm trying to figure out. But basically, the Veiled Woman healed me and opened a portal. I walk through it and here I am.
Her? But why? She does not have a mind. She does not have feelings.
She doesn't?
So why should she do this?
I didn't.
But still you speak the truth. I can feel it.
She doesn't have a mind.
Then could it really be that the unlikeliest of all eventualities has become reality and brought you here?
The unlikeliness of all eventualities? Are you saying that me being here is some kind of coincidence?
Coincidence or caprice, I do not know. The Veiled Woman cannot be understood.
True. But who are you? What are you?
I am sorry. It's been too long since I've spoken to anyone. I have had many names. The Akarians called me the God of Death.
The Akarians?
The Moonskin People, the Warden of Dreams.
Moonskin People.
The Pyreans, the Demon of the Deep. For your people, I am, or was, the Black Guardian.
Oh my god.
Pompous names, I know. However, I am none of these, neither god nor demon. I am only an eye, condemned to observe again and again.
You know the Pyreans. You know civilizations that are older than the Pyreans. Those other two you mentioned, I bet, are before the Pyreans even existed. So, how old are you?
As you measure time, older than your most daring chronicles go back, by far.
Yeah.
I have seen them all since our people fell. Every civilization, every cleansing, every turn of the cycle.
Are you the first civilization? You survived the cleansing of your civilization. Are you one of the ancient starlings?
What? No. The starlings came long after me.
Yeah, actually, I didn't think so.
I was only a fool who wanted to save his own skin at any cost.
I don't think you have skin right now.
I knew the cleansing would come. I had known it long before the Red Madness and the war started. But I also knew that fighting it as my people did, and as most do, was pointless. So I looked for another way to prevail. And I found it. What you see here is the result. The Goliath. As I liked to call it back then.
Goliath. What civilization is he from? Probably the first. The first ever civilization. Who knows how many millions, billions, or even more longer than that. And he's basically immortal, living inside this thing. There's a figure up there, though, moving. Looks like. What is the Goliath?
What is it? My self-dug grave. What it was meant to be was a body of steel, an immortal machine with which I planned to merge my consciousness. Only organic life could be reaped by the High Ones. And I thought that by becoming a machine, I could fool them. By the name of the Sun. How brilliant I thought myself. I wanted to become a god, laughing in the face of time. But let me spare you my self-pity. What happened, happened.
Immortality isn't all it's cracked up to be. Especially, it doesn't appear you can even move in this thing. So you plan to outlive your own people. To what point? Living in a dead world?
No. Joining the Goliath meant immortality. All I had to do was sleep and awaken once more when the cycle started again and new life came forth. Except that this new life would not have been defenseless. I would have been a true god to them. One capable of protecting them from the High Ones. No imaginary figure like the Creator. No false gods like the Lightborn were, to speak in your language.
So your plan didn't work. You built this machine, became it, and survived the cleansing. Well, I survived cleansings.
As the only one of my people? Yes. But it happened faster than it should have. And when the cleansing occurred, the Goliath was not yet finished. And as the Emperor unleashed the light, I had no choice but to complete the joining too early. A fatal error, as it turned out. I did survive, yes. But I am trapped inside this unfinished machine. And ever since then, all I can do is watch. Again and again.
I want to use my bow to zoom in and get a closer look, but I'm stuck in this. What do you mean you can only watch? We are thousands of leagues into the deep here, aren't we? What is there to see from here?
Yes. But a part of the Goliath is the eye. It allows me to see what happens on the surface everywhere. Not as literal as you imagine, of course. I see schemes, feel emotions, similar to your gift, to the Echo. But they are enough to understand.
He knows about my gift. So you've been here since the High Ones devoured your people?
Yes. It was not how I planned it. The Goliath in its final form was meant to be divine. A synthesis of man and steel. But I overestimated myself. And I acted too quickly, driven by fear.
Well, we haven't lost yet. Whether the High Ones triumph or not depends on what happens after Aranthiel has blown up the beacon.
No, no, you do not understand. You are stumbling through the fog, even now that it is almost over.
I believe it.
By themselves. The High Ones are not the problem. If we would just see them as they really are, they would become powerless.
As they really are. What are they? They become powerless?
Yes. It is hard to put into words.
Are you going to show
I myself do not know everything about the High Ones. Only that they are part of something we call the Cycle. A civilization arises and blossoms and then, always at the same stage of their development, the High Ones appear. And with them, the Red Madness. People start losing their minds, wars erupt, and chaos rules. Until 2 or 3 years later, the cleansing happens. The moment when the High Ones devour the collective consciousness, the gathered minds of this civilization, to give birth to a new one of their own. Despite all of this, nobody knows what drives them. Perhaps they act out of malice, out of an urge to survive, or perhaps they do not even have a will of their own, but are like a force of nature. But I do know one thing, as powerful as they might be, it is mankind who gives them that power. We make them into what they are, because what nobody understands is simply this. The High Ones feed on what humanity has the most of, their ego, greed. Pride, fear, and their everlasting search for an enemy who was responsible for all their misery. It is those traits the High Ones make use of. These characteristics are what make us human. And by themselves, they are harmless. Only when we bury them, when we deny them, then they play into the High Ones' hands. So why is this, you ask? It is simple. The High Ones alone cannot make the cleansing happen. Only a human can. With the beacon, my knowledge about it is as limited as my knowledge about the cycle. It has existed since the beginning of time.
You're kidding.
And despite what you might now believe, the ancient writings about it are true. Lit by the ones who carry the Numenos, it can banish the High Ones once and for all. But it can also destroy us. Because what happens when it is lit without a core is far more than an explosion. It is the cleansing, the triumph of the High Ones.
Oh my god.
And even as we speak, a human, Tialor Orinthiol, has done it again. A bright light will appear from the heart of the machine and open a hole in the sky.
I need to stop him.
It will spread throughout the world, and they will all feel it. A fire that burns them from within. A white light which will break through their flesh. Do you understand now? The High Ones have no power. All they do is to feed on our weaknesses, manipulate us into bringing about our own destruction. It is we who forge the sword that kills us. We who lead them to their victory. Even though the key to salvation has always been in our hands. But instead of realizing our folly, we make the same mistake. We repeat the same fate over and over. And only because we refuse to see the truth. Yes, the High Ones are our enemy. But who wants to hear that it is our ego, that dark voice within us, that empowers them? It is so ironic. The moment we would realize all this would be the